So, you've been lied to, my friends, but luckily, you're here at the right place. I'm going to be showing you why your social media currently isn't growing. We are going to hop on my computer over there, and I'm going to break it down for you. Here is what Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, here's what they don't want you to know. So let's hop into it. So guys, this is money, and this is what our friends over at Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, they love this. Like, they really, really love this. And they try to make as much of this as possible by any means. So let me go ahead and show you guys what I actually mean. So a lot of you guys are experiencing lower reach. And lower reach basically means pretty self-explanatory. You're not reaching all of your followers. You're not reaching all of your subscribers, all of your fans, whatever it may be. I'm going to use Instagram just as a model for this one. You can pretty much plug in YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, whatever you want in here. But I'm just going to use Instagram as an example. So yeah, they are causing you to get lower reach. Basically, what lower reach is going to equate to is less likes and less comments. Now, a combination of these two will cause you pain. The pain stems from the need for validation, and we all have a need for validation. It's why someone like me goes ahead and posts something like this and just starts to wait for the Instagram comments to roll in, right? We're all human. We want to be accepted. We want to be revered, whatever it may be. We all want validation, right? And that's why social media is just so addictive, because you get likes, you get comments, you get instant feedback, instant validation, right? So what they've gone ahead and done is they've lowered your reach, so you get less likes and comments. And I'm talking organically here. So yeah, lowered your reach to get less likes and less comments, right? And that leads to pain, right? Because once again, as I said, you have a need for validation. And pain always leads to action. Or pretty much 99% of the time. We are pain-driven. We are not inspiration-driven. We're pretty much pain-driven, right? We will avoid pain at all costs. That includes taking action. And in this case, it's financial action. So let me show you what I mean. They want you to go ahead and they want you to, as I said, for example, with Instagram, they want you to boost your Instagram post. And I'm sure a lot of you guys have played around with this, promoting your Instagram, to actually get more likes. I run a marketing agency. So when this first came out, I like freaked the fuck out. You know, I tried it with myself, tried it with some clients to no avail at all, right? This is like the equivalent of boosting a post on Facebook. Boosting a post on Facebook, it's great, but it's not going to lead to actual income. And it's, trust me, it's not going to lead to even an increase in followers, or at least it very rarely does, at least in my experience, right? So they want you to go ahead and do this. And do you ever notice, like, sometimes at the bottom of your Instagram post, it goes like this post is performing 95% better than your usual ones do. That's Instagram trying to get you to promote your post as much as possible. So this doesn't work in my experience. What does work is paid traffic. So for example, here is my ad espresso. Here's a little campaign I ran, 8.5 million impressions. I spent £63. That's roughly $80 or something like that. I got 37,000 clicks. I got a cost per click of take 1 pence and then divide it by 5. And that's my cost per click. Click through of 0.4%, which is not actually that great. So yeah, I reached 6 million people with this ad with a frequency of 1.42. That basically means frequency is basically how often someone sees it. So as you can see, some of the interests that I targeted, Tim Ferriss, Ty Lopez, Robert Kiyosaki, social media marketing. Tim Ferriss actually got me considerably higher click-through rates than some of the other stuff. If we actually go ahead and show all stuff like Tony Robbins, that didn't convert very well, business marketing, Grant Cardone. Once again, guys, I'm being super transparent here. Like, this is what the back end looks like. And here is the ad itself. It goes, how I made $10,000 last week or something like that. And this actually runs to a YouTube video. This was not a sponsored post on Instagram. This was an Instagram story advert, which has been converting amazing for me. And actually what I found is that when you run an Instagram story advert, you see where it says sponsored right here? Basically, usually your profile picture will be at the top here, and people can actually click on your profile picture as an advertiser and go straight to your profile. So look, when you're spending £60, like whatever, $80, and you're reaching 6 million people, imagine if I even got 2,000-3,000 followers from this. So look, if 1% of the people who see my ad actually click on my profile and they follow, I have just gotten 60,000 thousand followers, 60,000 followers for pretty much £63. Say 0.01% follow, that's 6,000 followers. You get my point here, right? So now you can see why I don't rely on this shit, because this shit is terrible. I rely on actual business manager, adverts manager, ads, you know, where I have some real data to look at. And this actually grew my YouTube, right? Remember, this is an ad going to my YouTube. This isn't an Instagram story. This is an ad trying to promote my Instagram. The Instagram grew as a byproduct of it. So yeah, basically I just wanted to show you guys that you can actually run separate ads, which I show you guys within Influencer Ignited. The swipe up leads back to the Instagram page, and there's more of an emphasis on them actually clicking your profile picture, and that converts even better. So yeah, as for how I'm getting all these crazy results and stuff like that, it's all in the targeting. As I said, I'm trying to be as transparent here as possible. You can see, you know, the sort of click-through rates and stuff like that. But yeah, it's all in the targeting. So all of this is going to be broken down in Influencer Ignited. How to run $5 a day ads to grow your Instagram. How to run $5 a day ads to grow your YouTube. How to run $5 a day ads to webinars so you can sell affiliate programs to, once again, make money for your personal brand. Whatever it may be, breaking this down in Influencer Ignited on a completely another level. In detail, you just can't imagine. But yeah, for those of you guys, for those of you guys that are only here for the freebies, that's cool too. I respect that. Yeah, I hope you got something from this. So yeah, let's hop back onto the vlogging camera.
So yeah, guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope that it shed a bit of light. I hope you now understand why you're not actually growing on social media organically. Now, I actually got inspiration for this video from one of my coaching clients. He actually came for an at-home coaching back in my home office in London. And yeah, he was just scratching his head as to why he wasn't growing organically. He was listening to all this like engagement group BS. Just your typical like 7 steps to growing your Instagram following in 2017, like that sort of BS video. Anyways, we managed to help him. He actually had a couple words to say, so I'm gonna leave that on screen now. It's around 60 seconds or so.
Hi guys, just finished up with my first session with Iman. Very, very great session. I'm a personal trainer, so I obviously, with my career, struggle to make money when I'm not working. So I'm only in one place at one time. So I wanted to look to make more passive income. We did exactly that. So we looked at affiliate marketing, where, you know, you recommend certain products with YouTube or Facebook or your social media. So another thing we looked at is how to grow your social media and your personal brand. So, and that we use that through paid traffic. So on Facebook advertising, that you can create an audience, you can control your traffic, and in turn, which is going to grow your social media, which in turn is then going to give you more of an audience, and how you can make more of a digital presence with, you know, ebooks or products or courses or things. So it gives me a lot more opportunity, which I'm really excited about. I've got loads of things now to do, but I couldn't recommend him enough, and I'm really, really excited for Influencer Ignited. So yeah, stay tuned for that one. It's really, really good.
So as you can see, we worked on a lot with him, and yeah, his social media has blown up since. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope you took something from it. And yeah, if you did, go ahead and subscribe. Just click that red button below. And if you're already subscribed, go ahead and click the bell right next to it. That basically means that you will get notified anytime a new dope ass video like this comes out. Anyways, guys, I will see you in the next one.